Hello student, today we are going to see the figures of speech. This topic or this question is asked for the 2 marks in our board question paper, and as well as in poetic devices there we are rhyme scheme, rhyming words also there, and figures of speech. Means there were the 2 marks for this question, for this activity. Maybe there is figure of speech or the poetic devices or rhyming words or rhyme scheme is asked in our board question paper there. So today we are going to see about the figures of speech. What is meant by figure of speech? A figure of speech, it is just like an ornament of language. An ornament, it decorate women also, as like this in literature it decorate language. Ornament, it decorate language also. It is departure from ordinary course of expression or course of ideas, and this device is always used deliberately in order to produce a greater effect in poetry there. Poet want his poetry, he want to create his poetry a greater effective there. So that's why poet use various types of figures of speech in his poem. He want to use the figurative language because for the greater effect. He want to create a greater effect there. So that's why he uses various types of figures of speech in his poetry. So in first part we have seen the figure of speech based on the resemblance, figures of speech based on the similarity there. In that first type we have seen simile, we have seen metaphor also there, apostrophe also there, and personification. That 4 figure of speech come under the resemblance or the similarity there. So let's see here the second type, the second classified type of the figure of speech, and that is figures of speech based on the contrast. So the first is antithesis. What is meant by antithesis? In antithesis, in this figure of speech, there is 2 opposite words, 2 opposite thoughts, 2 opposite ideas are used in this figure of speech. So here is also given the definition of this. We find the contrasting or striking opposite words or ideas combined in one sentence. So look at this, 2 ideas, 2 opposite sentences, 2 opposite words, sorry, 2 opposite thoughts, they are combined in one sentence. They are combined in one sentence, and then we understand about 2 opposite words are here, 2 opposite ideas are here, poet used 2 opposite thought. Why poet used here 2 opposite thought? What is the reason behind it? He want to make creative greater effect in his poem, in his poetry there. So for example, see here, poor ones laugh, rich ones frown, poor ones laugh, rich ones frown. So which 2 opposite words we can find here? Student, you can easily understand the when there is 2 opposite words, 2 opposite thought, 2 opposite ideas using, it is definitely antithesis figure of speech. So the here is example, poor one laugh, rich one frown. Poor and rich, laugh and frown, that is opposite words, opposite ideas poet use here. So how we explain it? There is 2 mark for this activity. when there is a given example in your question paper, so that time you should identify the figure of speech first of all. So then write here the name of this figure of speech and then explain. When you write the name of this figure of speech, you have got 1 mark, and when you explain it, then there is another 1 mark. It is that question have a 2 marks there. This activity have a 2 marks. So for example here, the example, poor one laugh, rich one frown. In explanation, antithesis, in front of this, the poor smile and the rich frown. This is opposite of what we expect here. Analyze this. Explain this sentence. What is poet use in this sentence? And then you have got the 1 mark also, your explanation there. So I hope you have understand about antithesis here. Two opposite words, two opposite ideas, two opposite thoughts are used in this figure of speech, and you can easily identify this figure of speech. Here is given an example for you, an explanation also given here. Second, figures of speech based on association, based on association. Association, see here. So first is metonymy. First is metonymy here. What is mean by metonymy? In this figure of speech, which is used to employ a particular object and we stand for a thing or a person there. See, what is explained in this figure of speech? It is used to employ a particular object and we stand for a thing or a person there. So for example is also explained here. It is only for your understanding, it is not from our textbook here. So pen is mightier than the sword. What is example here? Pen is mightier than the sword. So explain here, first of all write the name of figure of speech, metonymy, then explain what is the explanation of it. Pen stands for writer. Look at this. Pen stands for writer and sword stands for soldiers. That is given in this example. Pen is mightier than the sword. So what is the importance of pen? Poet want to explain the importance of pen. That is important, he explained there comparatively, pen is mightier than the sword. The sword is not important as like the pen. So pen stands for writer and sword stands for the soldier here. It is the metonym. Then next we will see here the fourth type of that is the classification of fourth type, the figure of speech based on the construction. Paradox. On construction first is paradox here. Here in this figure of speech also we find contrasting opposite ideas used very effectively, and the emphasis on the contrast there. Poet use the contrasting opposite ideas in paradox there. In our first poem, Song of the Open Road, you can see there. The example is also here. First of all, try to understand what is the definition of the paradox here. In this figure of speech, there is poet use the contrasting opposite ideas, and it used very effectively and as well as the poet emphasis on contrast here. Because why poet emphasis on the contrast here? readers must understand the importance of that things. Poet again and again emphasizes on specific thing and see the reason behind it. So for example, in first poem, I think song of open road here, still I hear, I carry my old delicious burden. Still I hear, I carry my old delicious burden. Poet says, I carry my old delicious burden here. Delicious and burden, both are contrasting things here. His burdens are delicious, and look at this, actually burdens are not delicious, but the poet used deliberately this word here. His burdens were delicious there. He emphasizes on contrast there. He emphasizes on the contrast because the poet find the pleasant burden here. He says his burdens were pleasant. They were delicious for himself there. And that is the contrasting things. So that's why see here, it is paradox. And how we explain it, just in one sentence you can write there. First of all, name of the figure of speech, paradox. Then in explanation, self-contradictory statement. It is self-contradictory statement as like this. So in second, onomatopoeia. See the pronunciation of this word, onomatopoeia. What is explained in onomatopoeia? In these figures of speech, there is the use of words, the imitating the sound or echo sound there. Imitating the sound or echo sound. In these figures of speech, the poet uses various type of words. Those are imitating the stands or the echo sound. Imitating sounds or the echo sound poet used there. For example, do hum like beads. Do hum like beads. How you explain there? First of all, write the name of figure of speech, onomatopoeia. The word hum imitate the humming of beads. The word hum is imitate the humming of beads here. Just you can understand about here. It is hum, it is sound expressing word. Hum, it is sound expressing word. Those natural words create a sound, express a sound that is come under the onomatopoeia. For example, rustling leaves. Rustling leaves. Rustling leaves. Rustling. It is express the sound of the leaves. It express the sound of the leaves. So that's why sound expressing word is rustling, and there is onomatopoeia figure of speech. Those sound create from the nature there, that is come under the onomatopoeia. For example, also twittering birds. Twittering birds, twitter. We cannot create artificially that sound. Only birds can twitter there. Okay? Only birds can twitter. Twittering birds. Which word is sound expressing here? Twitter. Twittering is sound expressing word. So that's why it is write the onomatopoeia. And which word is express the sound? For example, twittering birds. Twittering is sound expressing word. Or the another example, we can see here that is the murmur of waterfall. The murmur of waterfall, murmur, means whisper. Whispering of waterfall there. And waterfall, that murmur, it is also natural sound, it is not man-made. It is natural sound. So that's why in onomatopoeia, that sounds are come under in onomatopoeia there. So murmur is sound expressing words. So as like this onomatopoeia here, we have seen the definition of this figure of speech. In this figure of speech, there is the use of words, the imitating sound. Those sound imitate, or those sound echoing sound or echoing words are using poet there. So that's why it is onomatopoeia, figures of speech. So here, for example, I already told you about it. The word hum imitate the humming here. You can easily understand which is sound expressing word, which is imitating sound, which is echoing sound. You can easily identify about that sound. So here hum imitate the humming of bees. So I think we have completed that figure of speech which are in our textbook here. So thank you. We are stop here.